The Resident first aired in 2018, and since then has won everyone's hearts. The show is no stranger to emotional sequences, and there have been a handful of heartbreaking moments. So what are the most heartbreaking moments from The Resident? And what's going on with our beloved characters that everybody is divided over the verdict? Stick around till the end of the video to find out. Can anything be sadder than losing a beloved character? This isn't just a moment in the show. It's an entire freaking episode that finished off a whole box of tissues for many of us. Fans finally got to see the inevitable ever since the big news, the exit of Emily Van Camp from The Resident. There was a buzz since the news was announced over the summer, and everyone was anxious to see how Nick's end in the show was planned once Van Camp chose to leave the show ahead of season 5. The showrunners had to find a way to write out Nick right after season 4 ended on such good terms. While it makes sense, fans were still left understandably heartbroken when Nick was killed, watching Conrad mourn the loss of his wife, and seeing all the other characters also bid her farewell had our heart wrung dry of all the grief it could muster. Not to mention that even in death, her generous spirit lived on when her organs were donated and she made a trachea transplant possible for a patient suffering from COVID-19. And while the whole episode was incredibly heartbreaking and a total tearjerker, Long and Winding Road still remains one of the most brilliant episodes ever on The Resident. Why is this episode also one of the most brilliant ones in the show? The reason behind this brilliance is that the whole episode wasn't dedicated to building false hope in order to keep the audience hooked. We didn't go through the emotional torture of watching Conrad stay hopeful for his wife to live, only to be slammed in the face with her death in the end. Nick's brain death was confirmed halfway through the episode, and the viewers were allowed to grieve and say goodbye to her alongside the rest of the characters as they paid their respects. Characters got screen time to emotionally react to her death, and we got to process it with them. All those flashbacks caused quite a lot of tears, though, especially flashbacks paired with a character death. Maybe not in order, but it may be safe to say that The Resident worked through all 5 stages of grief with this episode: denial, anger, depression, bargaining, and acceptance. There wasn't anything particularly sensationalist about Nick's death. She didn't come in bloody and messed up. It was more about her dying and all the characters in the audience getting to process her death. Her death coming from a brain injury in a car crash probably still has some element of mystery to it, since there was no collision. But she looked peaceful in death, and that was the thing that softened the blow for all of us. But how did other characters respond to this devastating turn of events? We're diving into this and more right now, so get comfy. How did other characters respond to this surely devastating turn of events? Even though the characters were devastated, they also still had to keep composure and be able to handle the entire situation. For instance, Billy had to deal with the loss of her best friend while at the same time also treating her and also making Conrad come to understand what was going on. And throughout this all, we see her crying at times, even when she was doing her job. Belle called the organ transplant team for Nick's wishes to be honored, while Kit made attempts to push them away before she ultimately came round to insist on giving a speech to Conrad about Nick's organs on how they saved lives. Corbin Burnson was also heartbreaking, while Kyle was doing his very best to deny that he was soon going to be losing another of his daughters at Chastain, and made the declaration that he will never forgive Conrad for having followed Nick's wishes that she not be kept on a ventilator. Meanwhile, Marshall was also there to give support to his son and provide care to Gigi when Conrad wasn't able to do so. And throw in the whole line of people who adored Nick all in the hallway, there to pay tribute to her while she was being taken towards the surgical suite to have her organs harvested. With all that, there certainly isn't any way in the world that we're the only ones who had to constantly reach for the tissue box. But not all heartbreaks have to be fatal. And by fatal here, we mean physically fatal, since the show makes no attempt to avoid other heartbreaks that are fatal to the heart. And Priya asking Devin to leave Chastain could be that kind of moment for some. Priya has come across an amazing opportunity in San Fran, so she wants Devin to also leave, and she even made mention that she had also done the same thing for him before. Now that was quite a low blow, and it's also kind of unfair too, That's because Priya's career field and Devin's career field are very, very different. Being a journalist, Priya can still manage to work from ATL. However, for Devin, he needs to complete his residency before he even thinks of considering moving. The route to becoming a doctor is certainly not easy, and so moving could certainly cost him his whole career. So if Devin leaves, he'd have to then wait no less than a year before he can get back into the game. While you may say that he could also work on those medical devices, but at what cost? Hospitals are not really fond of out-of-practice residents since they are a bit of a liability. Therefore, in truth, Priya was really asking Devin to throw away his entire life plan just for her career. And to be honest, that's not really kosher. The one and perhaps only silver lining may be that Devin, despite getting punched as well as racially harassed, came to the realization that being a doctor really is his calling. Okay, enough with the heartbreaks. Let's talk about some lighter stuff. After all that, we certainly need some lighter stuff, and we've got some perfect trivia and food for thought about the characters coming up. Stick around to hear some juicy takes on your favorite characters. If you thought you knew them inside out, then you might want to rethink that. Could Devin Provish possibly be a playboy? In season 1, we meet Dr. Devin Provish as the naive and doe-eyed new doctor, under the mentorship of tough and demanding Conrad Hawkins. And Provish clearly doesn't understand to be the type of guy who would go about picking up women left, right, and center. But there certainly might be more to him than what the show let on. You don't have to know a lot of women to establish yourself as a playboy anyway. It just depends on how you treat the few women you do know. He'd been dating Priya Nair since right from the start of the show, but then went on to call off their engagement given his feelings towards Julian Booth. So isn't that the kind of thing a playboy might do? It really would seem reasonable to believe that he had cut Priya off since she had wanted him to quit Chastain and move along with her. However, the truth is that this may have been the opportunity he'd been waiting for all along. In fact, just some excuse so he could justify his action. This is something that's left fans kinda divided. Let us know what you think about Devin in the comments below. Conrad Hawkins could really be a super manipulator. Conrad Hawkins is central to the show, and while he can be cocky sometimes, he's still the tough, brilliant doctor everybody loves. He's the guy who pulls back the curtain on all the questionable things that happen in modern medicine today, and we love him for it. But one thing about this guy is that he could really be quite a manipulative person. You might not have picked this up during the show, however, in the episode titled Independence Day in Season 1, we can see him make use of his Machiavellian side on Noni Turner so he can get a heart transplant for his patient. Maybe you waved it off only as a one-time thing, but we also see him do this again. In the very next season, we witness him manipulating Dr. Provish. While he does this in order to preserve the life of his patients, it can't be ignored that he is still breaking the rules by making use of manipulative methods. He's demonstrated that he's willing to do whatever it might take, and will take whichever means to get things the way he wants, even if that means he has to make use of rather unscrupulous methods. So what's your verdict on what the most heartbreaking moment in the show is? Is it an entirely different moment? Tell us in the comments. And while you're at it, let us know whether you think Devin is a playboy or not. Make sure to give this a thumbs up if you're a true Resident fan, and subscribe to our channel for the more amazing content on your favorite shows.